On this project, I'm going to install a Bluox BX8869 towed vehicle bulb and socket lighting kit. What you get in here, and I've taken some of the parts out here, is basically get two light bulbs in a socket and the wiring so that you can connect an extra light bulb in the back of your taillights, and so that you can have an independent system. So that's hooked to the RV that you're towing this car with, and then that way you're not interfering with the taillights of the car, not having to use the dial kit or any of those kind of things. Now, if you watched my video on the base plate installation, you know that I had the grill off and stuff, I ran the wiring here from the location where those two little screws are there, where the connector will go. So I've already pre-wired it from there all the way up into here. So now I've got to find a way somewhere to get into the firewall so that I can go in the inside and down the path of the car and into the trunk with this four wire for the taillights. Well, I have this nylon fish tape. This is maybe a quarter inch diameter nylon that I bought from Harbor Freight for maybe $10. And this has been very indispensable over the years. And I found a spot right here. Grommet. And I'm going to try to kind of feed that through. But running the cabling for the taillights is going to unfortunately require drilling a hole in the firewall. I mean, there's just no way around it. So I'm practicing here with just a piece of sheet metal, and this first one is a grommet that goes into a 3/4 inch hole, and then I just put a little piece of half inch loom through here. So that's one possibility I can do. The other possibility is I've got this kit. So this looks like a grommet, except I just got a membrane on one side. And it should fit. I think it says it's within like a 16th or 32nd of an inch of what the recommended hole is. So that would certainly fit in there. And then you just puncture a hole when you're done. However, I think what I'm going to do, these I bought, and you can buy them individually. They're made by Hayco, and they're called snap grommets. And I buy these at Mauser.com, which is a big online electronics house, and you can buy them in a small quantity. But here's what they look like, and there's a hole in one end. The other end is no hole, but it's just a thin membrane. So essentially what you do is you poke this through the hole that you drilled, like so, and then, of course, I don't want to seat it in this material here, but it'll, as you pull through, it'll seat. So this is just about the right size. And once you put that through, you simply poke a hole in this end and then run your wires. And then to waterproof it, if you want, this is hollow in here, you can just inject some silicone sealant in there. So I think this is what I'm going to use. And I may use actually two of them. I have the trailer light wires to run through, which I think I'll use this. I'll use a second one for the breakaway switch. Now, when you drill holes, 3/8, 7/8 inch hole is not easy to drill in a car. Get yourself a step drill and buy a good one like this. This is an Irwin Unibit. Don't buy that made in China junk because you get it Harbor Freight and those kind of places, because they may not just work very well. Now, I'm thinking I can drill a hole right there.
Let's run it through that.
Which is underneath that grommet, and from the firewall side, that grommet is right down there. So that's what we're going to try. Yeah, I found I had to use a long extension on here so I could clear this pedal, but right there is the hole. Well, with great trepidation, I finally got that other grommet in there, and I got a piece of paracord here, so when I get the breakaway, I can run that through once I'm done. I'll fill that thing full of silicone. When you pull this trim off, sometimes these clips can get damaged, and they should have came off, not stayed in. So what I did is did some research and bought a whole box of new ones. And then so I can replace these old ones and get this thing back on right. Basically, what you just have to do is try to find a route from the front to the back. And I've found that I can use the void under the trim panels here. Now, when I put this one back on, I kind of squashed the wire a little bit. So, but on further inspection, I didn't damage it any. So be very careful when you put things back together that you don't mess up the wiring. And basically, what you want to do is want to make sure and cable tie the wire so it doesn't get anywhere near this little slot, because that's where the little metal clips fit in. And that's what happened, is I didn't tie off the front side enough, and this drifted over on top of that and got smashed in it. So make sure all these holes have clearance. So what we have here is we're in a trunk, and I'm exposed to taillights. Here's the wire. And that, I mean, we just had just enough. That goes to the front of the car, and then this is a crossover wire that goes from here through this tray and over to this side. And so the right side taillight and turn signal will be fed across to the main wire harness. It's a good idea to put wire loom like this in here, because you got some sharp edges in there and you don't want the wire to chafe. I have the taillight housing off, and I'm trying to figure out where to drill a hole for this light bulb. And when I turn it over, there's a couple spots. This place right here looks like it might be a winner. And the other possibility I found is in the top side, right up here. I have to remove this piece of plastic to do that. Actually, I think I might do it there, because it's flatter and it's going to be more central to the bezel, where the other thing's going to be kind of on the edge. So I think I might just drill it right here. After drilling a 1-inch hole here, I did install the light bulb. And I have a 12-volt power supply, so I'm going to hook that up and see how it works. So only one half is lit, because we only have one bulb. I think it's sufficient. Even though the whole bezel isn't on, at least half of the bezel is on, so that's enough probably. I think I'm going to run the wiring for the new light right in here. So I got to drill a 3/4-inch hole right here. Well, we have a nice 3/4-inch hole that I drilled with a step drill right in there. The next step then, take your grommet and then fit it in there until it snaps. There we go. Here's the grommet. What it looks like on the inside. Then we're going to feed our wires through there, and also feed a ground wire through there. Now we've prepared the end of our ground wire with a self-tapping screw that we're going to screw into the chassis so that we have continuity to ground. Now when you wire these lights up, you got to pay attention to the color codes. White goes to white, which is ground, and then the brown goes to brown, which is the taillight, and the green goes to black, which is the right turn signal. So we have all these connected. The kit came with some different barrel connectors. What I'm using are ones that are waterproof and heat shrink. So now what I gotta do is, this is basically heat shrink tubing, so I gotta heat the ends of these to shrink the tubing under the wire, which makes for a nice waterproof connection. And the last step here is just, I just wound some tape around it and put some silicone sealant on the grommet. It probably isn't required, but you know, I got it, so I might as well use some. Now I'm just going to put the taillight back on the passenger side, then we'll go over and do the driver's side. The wiring may seem a little bit difficult at first, but here's the four wires coming from the front. Now white is the ground wire, so what we've done is we are connected the white right into the vehicle ground here. Then we have a white wire also connected that goes over here to the ground side of the light. Which, if you remember, on this side we did the same thing. We put a wire from ground to the light. Okay, and then the yellow wire, which should be the left turn signal, just goes straight to this light. Likewise, the green wire, which is the right turn signal, goes to here, which is, this is the crossover cable that I did for the other side. But then the brown wire, since it's taillight, it comes from this wire harness to both left and right. So that's why we've got two wires here. One goes to left, one goes to right. So if you buy the Blue X kit, they give you a wiring diagram here that might help you. Well, now that we got the driver's side done, this is the cable that I added for the other light bulb. And I think it looks professional enough. Well, since Blue Ox didn't do a very good job here, I have to, what I had to do is I had to bend these up, because these actually were way down here. And even then, this thing won't fit. I thought about cutting these off and putting this behind, but I'd have to crawl into the ground because it had to be so far behind that I don't think that's doable. So what I end up doing is tapping these out, quarter 20, then buying longer bolts with a little nylon spacer, and then that will go in there. And it's going to look kind of ugly. It's going to stick out like that, and I don't really, well, be around like this. I don't like it per se, but I'm out of options, basically. At least it's not damaging the grill. So I can always decide, if I come up with some better idea of mounting this somewhere else, I can always do that. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to just put some anti-seize on here. Put those in. And then wire this up, and then we'll be done. I guess it doesn't look too bad. I've seen some installations that are worse. And at least I didn't have to cut into the fascia or the grill. I may end up painting these maybe black. Paint these black maybe. And, you know, it works pretty good. Now, the only thing is that it does rub here a little bit. I probably could put a washer behind it. But what I think I'll do is get some red tape and then just put red tape behind here so it doesn't rub on it. And then maybe the same thing here, because it's marring a little bit from the this is where the tabs go. So I've also wired it up. This is a 6 contact connector, and the wiring harness that I use is only 4, so it leaves 2 spares. Well, actually, for the 6 wire connector, position 5 and position 6 are for electric brakes and for 12 volts or backup lights. What I'm going to use the 12 volts for is I'm going to run from 12 volts up into the engine compartment. I'm going to install a battery charger so that the 12 volts coming from the motorhome will charge the Toad's battery here. And then that way, you know, you're not going to have a dead battery when you get to your destination. So I wired the 4 wires in for now for the taillights, and then when I get the battery charger in, then I'll add that to it. This is the taillights from the vehicle lights. So we're going to go ahead and turn the other light on now. Okay, go ahead. And actually, they get a slightly bit brighter. Go ahead and turn it off. See that? So actually, let me zoom in a little bit. Turn it on again. Turn it off. So actually, our taillights going to the RV are a little bit brighter than the lights that are in the car. So that's great. We're all set. Okay, now we'll do a brake light test, because that should be a little bit brighter. Okay, brake light. Yeah, that's a little brighter. So this project pretty much is a wrap.